this thing that girls oh, for example, this one, that is the, that you invite the girl and she will come with her friend to your house. It should stop in 2018. It should stop in 2017. Girls should not bring it to 2018. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Can you guys notice my Santa outfit? I went all out. Yeah, this is my own little way of, you know, being in the Christmas spirit, you know. So yeah, welcome to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. Today we are going to be talking about resolutions for 2018. Yes, I know you're probably rolling your eyes at me like it's too early to probably think about that, or maybe you're just telling yourself that, you know, when it's the end of the year, people come up with all the craziest resolutions in the world. I'm going to eat healthy, I might even go vegan, I'm going to exercise 24/7, you know. But ask them, like February, they are doing none of these things. Well, I'm not coming here to tell you to maybe go vegan or, you know, change your lifestyle or stuff like that. Some of the things I'm going to mention, I would just love to see them happen more in 2018, starting with myself. So yeah, it's nothing extraordinary, but you know, just the little details that I think we should incorporate into our 2018. And I had to write them down. I did, so I don't come on here and forget something. The first thing I would love to talk about is to live and let live. Like, that's something all of us need to carry into 2018. Bottom line, what do I mean by live and let live? Is learning to tolerate the opinions or behaviors of others, and similarly, they too tolerate us. You know, I have realized that, for example, simply put, my husband would think differently about certain things, and I wouldn't. You know, like looking at a particular situation, the way I'll think about it, his opinion about it is going to be completely different. That is okay. We need to learn to tolerate the behaviors of others and their ways of thinking in 2018. You know, bottom line, we need to judge less. It's the same thing. You know this statement, like the letter six, the number six, sorry. Like the number six, looking at it from this point, it may look like six, but you looking at it from the other side, it's going to look like nine. So yeah, I hope you learn to live and let live in 2018. The second thing I wrote down was to let go and let God. I have struggled on my own in 2017, and most of the times I felt frustrated. I had a breakdown and I cried. And other times when I had a similarly, when I found myself like in a difficult situation, and I turned to God and I prayed about it and I just completely gave it to Him, somehow there was a solution to that problem. I really, really intend to carry that behavior into 2018, to just let go and let God. I cannot control everything that happens around me, you know, but He is in control all the time. So what else? I learned this many years ago while I was in uni. I was watching some program, and yeah, I have not really practiced that thing, but somehow when I just sat down, I was thinking, like, you know, video ideas and stuff, it came to my mind. What I would like to propose to you guys is the spirit of gratitude. But yeah, I know it's easier said than done. Like, you know, everybody will be like, be more grateful about the stuff that happens to you. But how do you practice that? The one easy way I would love to propose to you guys, especially, I would propose that you do this during dinner. For example, at the end of the day, when you sit down with your family to have dinner, mention one high and one low of your entire day. Like, give everybody the chance to go around, starting from the 1 year old child to the 2 year old child, to mention one high and one low. It could be anything. My low could be the fact that my alarm woke me up late and I went to work late, and you know, my bosses were pissed off and stuff like that. My high could be what, like, maybe I got into, on my way back home, I had a nice comfortable seat in the bus and I relaxed, you know, and I came home comfortably. Yeah, if you practice this more, if you learn to you know, look back at your day and think of one low and one high, it would just remind you that it could have been worse. But here you are, seated with your beautiful family. God has blessed you with a meal on your table. You're about to have dinner. The homeless may not have that. Some orphans somewhere may not have that. Some war-torn countries may not be able to have dinner. So yeah, I think that's something we should definitely carry into 18, the fourth thing I would love to propose to you guys is to start that venture. If there's one thing I am genuinely really proud of myself, is the fact that I started my YouTube channel in 2017. Yes, I am very proud to say it. You know, if you've been writing tons and tons of ideas in a book, there are some of you watching this video that if you were to open your diary to somebody, they will see like 100, I mean, amazing ideas that you've been writing on. So why don't you start it? It could be that business, it could be a hobby, maybe you're afraid of heights. Go ahead and try it. You just need to start. Bottom line, this whole point that I'm making is to start in 2018. Start that thing that you've been talking about the entire 2017. Start that thing that you've been writing tons and tons of pages about. Just go right ahead and start. And the last thing that I wanted to tell you guys or share with you guys, which I think we all should incorporate into in 2018, to live in the moment. I know this is, again, this is easier said than done, but YOLO, you only live once. And I read this other quote somewhere, if you do it right, once is enough. You wouldn't have to maybe ask God that to ask God to send you on earth again. If you live the one life you have, if you live it right and do all the things you have always wanted to do, once will be enough. And I also read this somewhere and I wrote it down. It's not the place where you celebrate Christmas that matters. It's the friends and the family that we surround ourselves with that matters. Yeah, we should just sometimes learn to live in the moment in 2018. At the beginning of January, if you practice this like just a little, at the end of the month of January, you take time to just sit down and, you know, just look back at your month. When did you actually live in the moment? I bet you December 2018, you would have had like 12 beautiful, unforgettable moments. You actually, you know, stopped thinking about anything and actually lived in that moment. So yeah, that's everything I wanted to come on here in the spirit of Christmas. I am not Santa, though I'm wearing his outfit. Yeah, but the one thing I wouldn't end this video without asking you guys is this thing I've been seeing online. A couple of things that everybody is doing it, like, you know, this thing should stop in 2018. I have seen tons and tons of things. For example, what should stop in 20? Like, what crazy one have I read? This thing that girls for example, this one that is that you invite the girl and she will come with her friend to your house. It should stop in 2018. It should stop in 2017. Girls should not bring it into 2018. So yeah, let me know in the comment section what you think should stop in 2017. Like, you don't want to see it happen in 2018. So thank you guys for watching this video. Merry Christmas. It's 4 days to Christmas. I cannot believe it. 2017 is ending. I am positive 2018 is going to be amazing. I have to speak it into existence and I believe it is going to truly be amazing. So see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to click that subscribe button. Bye.